Welcome back to Let's Play Castlevania, Lords of Shadow. I'm BurningDogFace, and I thought before I started recording today I would pop into some of the earlier levels and see if I could find any new goodies. And, well, this is the level in Chapter 2 that's just called Agartha. You know, as opposed to Waterfalls of Agartha, or Outskirts of Agartha, or whatever. And, I couldn't help but notice this. Awesome. Rad. Dagger upgrade. Of course, now I actually have to finish the level to get to keep it. Oh, also, you can't really see it because I can't move the camera, but right here, just south of here, is one of those, you know, wooden dock-looking points to where I had to jump across at the warg. And, I can just do that now, because I can do this. The warg didn't even appear. Which is kind of cool. I'm, still gonna keep scouring the level, because, one, I have to, I think, if I want to keep this upgrade. And two, there's also a life gem, that I haven't found somewhere in this level. Oh, and the trial is, don't use, shadow magic here. So I think I can manage that. Anyway, I'll see you guys on the other side, because I know you don't want to watch me retrace my steps. Not to mention how obsessively I'll be peeking into corners this time, looking for, loot. So, jump cut! Well, that's the level. I still didn't find the life gem, and there's still a shadow gem in there somewhere I've missed. And I don't know about getting all the power upgrades, but I really want to get all the life upgrades for the end of the game, because I'm really taking a hammering from some of these enemies. I still found the dagger upgrade. And I handily beat the level without using shadow magic, so there's that. Sure, I've had this available for long enough. Yay! I don't know that I've ever actually used Chain Bear. Oh, that one. Yeah, okay. What's this do? Alright, that sounds useful. A little bit more punch to this thing. Trial complete. Chapter 4. Mountain Fortress.
The deed is done. Cornell is no more. Such a pity that the Brotherhood of Light, the order to which we both belong, should also be the reason why the world is in such chaos. Gabriel, you have proven your worth, my friend. You have a piece of the God Mask. It is said this relic can bring back the dead. It is said this relic can bestow power beyond any man's reckoning. Now, with the help of the old god, he heads toward the land of the vampires and further into the heart of darkness.
You know, this isn't a good example, but, sorry. That was a really poor time on my part. This isn't a great example of it, but, the way Zobek words some of these loading screen, intros makes me suspect he's got more going on than he's ever let Gabriel know. I don't know, just some of the things he says sound kind of fishy. He was supposed to clear the way in the land of vampires, so maybe we'll, get to talk to him about it.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Nothing there. I thought those were bats over in the distance. I guess it is a bit early for that. In the day, I mean, not in the game. Evil exists here, insidious evil that consumes men's bravery. It seems lurking in the castle is an ogre. I find it incredible that childhood stories can turn out to be true. I remember my father reading to me tales of these creatures when I was a boy, and, if memory serves, they are slow and ponderous when attacking. What I need is something that will allow me to run fast and move quickly if I have a fighting chance against this giant beast. The walls of the mountain fortress rose up on the horizon, waiting for the courageous hero. Right, okay. I know, you just said that. Alright, hold this. Actually looking in the background for potential hiddenness. Ah! I didn't see you, but... Awesome! If I'd found the one in Agartha, I would have just gotten my health back up. Frustrating! Okay, it's just a wall. I don't know why they built steps there, but... Oh, I see. Yeah, let's do that. I remember, for the longest time, I thought that, this game had originally been a completely unrelated action game, and they'd, made this game as Lords of Shadow, and then, slapped some of the Castlevania elements in there, like giving the main character the last name of Belmont instead of just calling him Gabriel, in order to make the game sell better. I actually learned recently that let's do that other thing they said, then. Nice. Thanks, brother. Yeah, I actually learned recently that it's kind of the other way around. See, when they first announced this game, it was, under the title, Lords of Shadow, but they'd always meant for it to be a Castlevania game. Can I go down? Oh yeah, I can go down there, except it just leads me to death. I didn't even hit A or anything, he says, nope, I'm gonna let go now. Yeah, they announced this game as Lords of Shadow, and are very vague about it, because, if I understand this correctly, really soon after the announcement, they were releasing another Castlevania game, except this one wasn't the kind of Castlevania game the fans really wanted. It was a fighting game on the Wii called Castlevania Judgment. Fuck. I don't know. In my experience, a third-party game being exclusive to the Nintendo Wii generally didn't lead to great things. Finish that. It's a fighting game with the with a bunch of characters from throughout Castlevania, so you can have Simon Belmont fight Alucard, or I believe they threw in the heroine of Order of Ecclesia, which had just come out at that point. Anyway, that was going to come out before this game here. And they were worried that, if they announced this before Judgment came out, it would completely overshadow that game. And people would say, well, screw the fighting game, I'm gonna wait for the real Castlevania game. So they announced this as Lords of Shadow, and, only made the, real, title clear after the game, the Judgment game came out. By the way, for the record, I heard that was terrible. Skills? No, not skills. Scrolls! Down here! As we feared, the fortress has been overrun by evil forces. A terrible bird-like creature has made the tower her personal nest, and a huge monster roams around the old castle walls, protecting it. I've heard nothing from the other knights, so I'll assume the worst and try to return to the Brotherhood to inform them that this pass is held against us. What am I not seeing? That's weird. Well, there you go. One of those climby platforms that doesn't go anywhere. Maybe it's the exception that proves the rule, whatever that means. I never really understood that saying. Oh, shit. An enormous monster appeared on the other side of the wall, roaring ferociously. Fucking hell. Thank you. Oh good, a giant hand. Ah, fuck! Shank that hand! Shank it! Always be shanking! Don't mind if I do! I am no one's dolly! Should have made put a hand up in the corner, just saying. This isn't gonna kill him. I don't think this will even destroy his hand. Really? You want me to... Okay, I don't have to go in the hole. You know, that would be stupid. Oh god. Well, so much for using that shrine ever. Ogre. Size giant, difficulty high. And he's immune to everything except the crystal, which I don't think I have right now. The Anubian giants are an ancient species, as old as the Earth itself. This particular ogre is one of the last of his race left in the world. Why do I keep doing that? He lives amongst the walls of this deserted mountain fortress, waiting for misguided travelers to stumble in so that he can grind their bones to make his bread. However, this particular ogre hasn't had much man flesh for quite some time, having to settle for the odd cave troll. Ogres have an extremely keen sense of smell, can sniff a man from half a mile away, making them very successful trackers. Fortunately, their size and clumsy nature means that their prey can often see them coming. Oh god. Move! Hey, I beat the Colossus, man. I know how to take on something that wants to smash you with its hands. Oh. Alright, not bad. Fuck. I couldn't even tell if I was turning it on or off just there. I've just realized that the reason he's standing behind that thing is that he's probably got junk. Damn it. Ah! Nope. Just the one thing I had. And he's immortal for some reason. Oh, I see. Ooh! No, he doesn't have junk. It's just a very suggestive place to stand. Quiet, you. The ogre smashed and smashed in an attempt to crush the annoying human that kept bothering him. Thanks, timer. I really appreciate that. I rolled into it! Alright. I'm Burning Dogface. And I'll see you in the next episode of Let's Play Castlevania, Lords of Shadow. When we keep taking on this big douchebag. Later!